As autumn approaches, so does the season for Brighton's Rainbow Fund come upon us. And they will be deciding how the money is distributed from the funds raised at Brighton Pride this year. One of the recipients in previous years has been the Brighton and Hove Community Safety Forum. And I have Billy Lewis from the LGBT Community Safety Forum here to talk about it. How much impact does that have on what you're able to do?
Massive, massive. We wouldn't be able to do a lot of the work that we do without that money.
And this year you've actually been able to open a central hub.
Yeah, well, we had an idea of a one-stop shop. It was something that was coming through our trust and confidence survey that we hold each year, that people wanted a one-stop shop, basically, somewhere that they could go to that was LGBT specific. So the Rainbow Fund have created the Rainbow Hub. We're tenants in there on one of the floors. So we're operating from the Rainbow Hub on St. James's Street. It's where we're now there during the week. And the Rainbow Hub will have its own entity of volunteers as well, so that we can do some signposting and joint work so that people can come in and make appointments to other services.
And how is awareness showing for this? People coming along?
Yeah, no, we have people that are dropping in all the time. I mean, from anything from people to just pop in and have a coffee and talk about what's going on for them in their life, to people reporting a hate crime or asking for one of us to go over to the police station with them, different information that they need in the area, we have people that come in and ask for different support groups. We're already really busy.
Well, you're already a busy person running the safety forum with your volunteers, and yep, it's full time for you.
Yep.
How are you coping with running a shop as well? I mean, is that staffed by volunteers?
At the moment it is, yeah. So the safety forum volunteers are in there constantly. But now that the Rainbow Hub is its own entity, that's going to have its own base of volunteers that can man and meet and greet and do a lot of the initial work, not so much signposting, because that's something we're trying to avoid, but certainly to help make appointments for other organisations and stuff when people come in off the street. So that's happening.
And do you have enough volunteers?
We always need volunteers. It would be really silly to say that we've got enough volunteers, but we always need people to come and volunteer for the forum and for the Rainbow Hub.
So if people were interested, how would they get in touch with you, Billy?
So you could pop in 93 St. James's Street, or you can contact us on our website, LGBT-help, or you can go to the Rainbow Fund directly if you'd like to volunteer for the Rainbow Fund and the Hub.
And people could do as little as an afternoon or several days.
Yeah, admin, meeting and greeting, being trained up on how to advocate and to give people advice. That's essentially what the Hub's going to become, is like an info centre and a point of reference for support. So we don't tell people to go away and come back next week. We try to make an appointment for them there and then, or on one of our scheduled partner calendars.
That sounds absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much. Thank you for the hard work that you and your team put in
Thank you.
In keeping the city safe for the LGBT Cheers. Community.
Thank you.